Yo, what's up? It's your boy, Set V. You might know me as DJ Info. Or if you went to ASR, I was the little boy rapping college. But anyways, so, like, I used to do drugs. And, like, after doing drugs and doing the programs and stuff, I have to do everything known, you know, to have quality in my life, to have, you know, to be trusted, to be supported by the community. You have to do everything, like, known. So it's like, when it comes down to relationships, I mean, since back in the days, you know, my shit had to be known. I had a relationship with a girl, and everybody knew her, and, like, it was a supportive relationship. But, you know, it's like, you know, everybody liked her. She was the prettiest girl in school, you know. So it was kind of hard when every guy is trying to, like, tear you apart. But anyways, so when it comes down to being a cool guy, dude, it's like into the 2000s and shit. You got to be known on every level, you know, because you want to appreciate your relationship. And you don't want to be looked at like a hooch bag, you know, like you're playing tricks and tips and shit, you know. So it's like, it's different when you're in a supportive relationship, because I was in a relationship with a girl and her mom wasn't feeling it, and it affected me as a guy, you know. I was suffering from angry mama syndrome, you know. Even though I did everything the right way, like I told her mom she was gonna come live with me and shit, you know, her mom was just angry, you know, and it wasn't my fault, you know, but I suffered the wrath of angry mom. You know, and I know what it's like to be in a supportive relationship where her mom knows you, her family knows you. It's a different thing, because then you're too busy thinking about your future. You know, you're thinking about, fuck, like, how are we going to get through the situation? Where are we going to be tomorrow? Then you're able to build a relationship that's worth having, you know what I mean? And then you can go fuck around everywhere. You know, you can fuck on the street and be like, fuck it. You can be the biggest hoe in the world, bro. You know, you can even get through drugs when you're supported. You know, when you're known, because like me and my other girlfriend, we used to do drugs together, and the whole fucking block, the whole fucking hood, the whole fucking neighborhood knew we was fucking up. It was Jen and Sadway, the fucking tweaker couple. They kept fucking. If you was fucking tweaking and you was in a relationship, we were the fucking washing machines for you fucks. So you know, if you ever get local in North Long Beach, and you know me, Sam Velasquez, who used to live on 63rd Street, you know, on fucking 454, that building, right, that house, me and my girlfriend used to be the tweaker power cup, my boy. Like, we were the naughties for you motherfuckers. We didn't go around robbing people. We didn't go around cheating on each other. We were faithful as fuck, you know what I mean? But anyways, but, you know, the world knew what we were doing, and we respected ourselves, and, you know, whatever, but we got through drugs, whatever. So, but anyways, but when you have family support, you can get through anything, you know what I mean? It's just I had never gone through the program. I had never did the steps. I had never wanted to quit. And, you know, she's what started me quitting, you know, no lie. But anyways, it's different when you have family support, because then you can actually have a relationship, you know, and then you can, like, especially if there's kids involved. Like, if the family supports you, then you can be the stepdad to step in. If the family doesn't support you, it's a lot harder, you know. When there's a kid involved, it takes a little bit more effort, but you can do it. Because you have to deal with not only her family, but his family, you know. His homies, his hood, his area, his place, you know. And they diss motherfuckers when they can't be a good dad, you know. But that's just, you know, everybody has different tools for motivation and different, you know, it's different. But, like, when you're in a supportive relationship, when you're in a relationship where the mom at least knows your ass, you know, it's way different. You don't got to deal with the hood shit. You don't got to deal with the black daddy, the black boyfriend pretending to be the black daddy. You know, you don't have to go through all that shit, because you're dealing directly with her friends, her family, the people that matter. I'm not saying that the wall of darkness doesn't matter, but it does, you know. But it just makes life a lot different. It makes future possible. Because, I mean, there's just dating a girl, but then there's trying to make a future with the girl. So if you can't make a future with her and your future is not, like, possible, then it just sucks. I don't know. It's just, you know, after doing drugs and getting over that shit and having to be known, I just saw the difference between on the download dating, you know, without family knowing or anybody else knowing, and you could fall into traps and shit. You get tricked out. You get your bank account's empty and shit, and you end up on drugs. That's what happens when you're not in a known relationship. When you're in a known relationship, you're not getting trapped up. She's not using you for your money. She's not fucking hoeing it. You're not doing drugs, because it's a known relationship. You see, you have to take that leap of, like, yo, let me meet your family, your friends, because then it's a real relationship. It's not some kid play shit. So, I don't know. So nowadays, to be a good guy, I suggest you have to be in a known relationship just to keep yourself safe, just to keep her safe, just to be able to enjoy the relationship, you know, because otherwise you're going to fall into trick shit. You're going to fall into drugs. You're going to fall into the she loves the black dudes and you're going to get bullied by a black hood or something because you never tried, you know. So just to get past all those annoying life traps and shit like that, it's better just to be in an old relationship, you know, because then you're able to have personal success, you know, and then you're not a target for, like, fucking couples banging on single people, you know. You know, and it's different when you're in a known relationship, because Sidebuster man can't be like, yo, that's my girl, though. That's my girl, though. Yo, that's my girl, though. Yo, hey, little homie, that's my girl, though. You know, that annoying shit. And those are the tribal problems you get when you're not in a known relationship. You know what I mean? The pimpologist and then that annoying shit. You know, all that annoying shit. If you can't get past that annoying motherfucker, you can't be with it. Unless you fucking talk to her parents and talk to her family, whatever. You know how annoying motherfuckers are these days. But anyways, it's your boy said V, venting out right here.